What if I told you we had the ability to text each other in 1933? What? Well, before the advent of texting and even before faxing, and I'm sure some of you young people are now wondering what a fax is, there was the Telex, which stood for Telegraph Exchange. It's now a long forgotten technology used mainly by businesses to transmit short messages to each other. Kind of like texting, but attached to telephone wires using devices you definitely couldn't put in your pocket. The Telex began in Germany as an R&D project in 1926 and became an operational teleprinter service in 1933. The service, operated by Reichspost, the German postal service, had a speed of 50 baud, that's approximately 66 words a minute. Compare that to dial-up, which made it to around 30,000 baud before we all jumped ship and switched to broadband around 2000 because dial-up was so heinously slow. Telegrams have been popular since the late 19th century, even before the telephone. Telegrams were short messages sent between telegram offices by specially trained telegram operators who would feverishly tap out your message. Once a message had been manually sent and received, it would be delivered by a telegram messenger, probably on a penny farthing because it was the 19th century and that's what everyone wrote, probably. By the late 19th century, this was becoming automated, but telegrams were still processed through central telegraph offices. Telexes were essentially the next generation of telegram. Instead of having to schlep all the way down to the telegraph office and tell your confidential message about your super secret business deal to some snotty ook of a telegraph operator, you simply typed your message onto a telex machine and it was automatically sent to a similar machine somewhere else in the world where it could be read instantaneously on a small piece of paper tape. Telegraphy had originally used Morse code to transmit messages, but by the 1870s human operators were being replaced by teleprinters and Morse code was replaced by the Baudo character encoding system, which had the advantage of using the same 5-bit length code for every character, so making it easier to automate using the machinery of the day. Baudo was the forerunner of the familiar ASCII character codes used in computers today. Instead of ASCII's 8 bits, Baudo had 5 bits to encode data, which amounted to 32 different combinations. The smart ones among you will realise that with a 26-letter alphabet and 10-digit numbering system, that really doesn't fit into 32. So Baudo codes in the late 19th century only used A to Z, plus a couple of control characters. Baudo ITA 2, which was the next generation, was used for telex, and this used 2 control codes to move between letters and figures mode, providing most common characters plus control codes familiar to those who use ASCII, such as carriage return and line feed. Like ASCII has versions for different countries, Baudo had country-specific versions, so characters like the UK pound sign could be added. Interestingly, the most common letters used the fewest holes because it minimised the fatigue on the machinery. Baudo, of course, missed the whole concept of emojis, so thankfully telex machines were incapable of printing eggplants or poop emojis. The usual method of operation was that the message would be prepared offline using paper tape. So if you've ever wondered why paper tape in early computers had 5 holes, now you know. Many early telex machines incorporated a 5-hole paper tape punch and reader. Once the paper tape had been prepared, the message could be transmitted in minimum time. Telex billing was always by connected duration, so minimising the connected time saved money. However, it was always possible to connect in real time, where the sender and the recipient could both type on the keyboard, and these characters would be immediately printed on the distant machine. Telex messages were routed by addressing them to a telex address, for example 14910 Eric S, where 14910 is the subscriber number, Eric is the abbreviation of the subscriber's name, and S is the country code, in this case Sweden. It was also possible to automatically route the message to different telex terminals within a subscriber organisation by using different terminal identities, for example plus T148. The machines would start conversing by sending a series of regularly timed pulses to essentially determine the baud communication rate. Once connected, the "Who are you?" code would establish a connection and then communication would begin. With concerns today about privacy and messaging apps like WhatsApp using 128-bit encryption, it's odd to see that there was almost no communication security in the telex system. In the USA, the Teletypewriter Exchange Service, or TWX, was introduced by AT&T in 1931, transmitting that same 50 baud. But they soon developed a second generation of TWX called 4-row that went at a blistering 110 baud. Bell Labs created a competing system in the 1930s running at 75 baud. TWX used the public switch telephone network. In addition to having separate area codes for the TWX service, the TWX lines were also set up with a special class of service to prevent connections from regular telephone lines to TWX and vice versa. Western Union purchased the TWX system from AT&T in January 1969. Canada operated a similar service through the CPR Telegraph Company and CN Telegraph in 1957. In the UK, Telex began as an evolution from the 1930s Telex printogram service. It started as a direct teleprinter-to-teleprinter service in 1932, but by 1945, as traffic increased, it was decided to have a separate network for Telex traffic, and the first manual exchange opened in London. In the late 1950s, the decision was made to convert to automatic switching, and this was completed by 1961. There were 21 exchanges spread across the country, with one international exchange in London. Telex service spread within Europe, and particularly after we'd all stopped fighting in 1945, around the world. Long before automatic telephony became available, most countries, even in Central Africa and Asia, had at least a few high-frequency shortwave telex links. By 1978, West Germany alone had over 120,000 telex connections. Even the place where my mum worked had a telex, and I remember looking at it and thinking what a cool piece of tech it was, and that I really wanted to mess with it. But given anything I'd mess with I'd break when I was a kid, they rightly didn't let me anywhere near it. By the early 1990s, telex was quickly replaced by the fax machine, which allowed whole sheets of paper to be digitised and sent, allowing not just short messages, but whole business documents. Fax had a much shorter life than the telex, with communications over the internet making it largely irrelevant in just 20 years. Telex machines quickly went the way of the dodo. British Telecom stopped offering the Telex service to new customers in 2004 and discontinued the service in 2008. They sold off their services to Swiss Telex, which still provide Telex services to this day. iTelegram offers Telex-like service without subscriber Telex lines. Individual subscribers can use Deskmail, a Windows program that connects to the iTelegram Telex network, but this uses the internet as the last mile. If you like these videos and want to see more, then feel free to subscribe. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next video.